In 1986, Bobby Earl Ferguson lives in Okopee, Florida with his grandmother Evangeline. Detective Wilcox arrives to him and arrests him without explanation. The grandmother tries to fight off the grandson, but it does not end with success. The detective takes Bobby away. At the police station, a detective brutally beats Bobby. Sheriff Tanny Brown comes into the room and we are immediately transported to the events 8 years later. Grandma Evangeline arrives in town for a debate with Professor Paul Armstrong. In his report, Paul tells the public about the humanity and injustice of the death penalty. At the end of the debate, Evangeline hands a letter to the professor from her grandson. The letter says that Bobby denies his guilt and asks Paul to consider his case. After reviewing the letter, Armstrong refuses to take part in this. Evangeline insists, but after a setback, she leaves. Paul Armstrong returns home where he is greeted by the children who came in honor of his daughter Katie's birthday. Professor Laurie's wife is a former assistant prosecutor. After Paul told her that Bobby Earl was asking for his help, she insists that Armstrong take up the case. The professor makes an appointment with Evangeline in which he says that he agrees. After arriving in Florida, Paul and Laurie are met by her parents. Sometime later, the professor and his wife's father went to his office, where he met Dolores. Dolores takes Armstrong to the archive. The professor began to get acquainted with the case in which it is said that Bobby Earl killed a young girl named Joni Shriver 8 years earlier. The next day, Paul goes to the prison where Bobby Earl is imprisoned. Armstrong turns on the recorder and they start talking. The guy tells in detail that 8 years ago after his arrest he was brutally beaten, tortured by lack of water and food and played Russian roulette with him in order for him to confess. After a while, he had to confess to something he hadn't done. After meeting with Bobby, the professor went to the person who performed the autopsy of the girl and made a conclusion on that case. Armstrong claims that some details could have been obtained indirectly as a result of Bobby's torture. But the woman is not particularly involved and says that everything was done cleanly. After Paul left the building, Detective Wilcox was waiting for him, who made the arrest of Bobby. And this is the same detective who beat Bobby according to him. Wilcox is trying to find out for what purpose Armstrong appeared and is stirring up old cases. Then the professor went to the lawyer who defended Bobby 8 years ago. The professor is interested in why the lawyer did not take into account all the details in Bobby's testimony. The lawyer reports that the death of the girl was a great tragedy for the whole city. And if Bobby had been acquitted in this case, the city would not have forgiven him for it. Then Armstrong went to the girl's teacher. She told in detail what she remembered from that day. After the meeting with the teacher, Sheriff Tanny Brown was waiting for the professor, who, according to Bobby's testimony, played Russian roulette with him and took part in knocking out testimony. Sheriff takes Armstrong to the scene of the attack, where he tells in detail about the murder that happened. The professor is haunted by the fact that the city is literally obsessed with this case, and returning to the hotel room, he calls his daughter to make sure that everything is in order at home. The next day, Paul finds his car painted and broken. Local detectives inform him that the city does not like that the professor is interested in the old case. Arriving at the station, Armstrong reports that he is aware that Bobby's confession was given under pressure. A dazed Wilcox attacks him, but the sheriff calms him down. The sheriff also reports that Bobby Earl has already been detained on a similar case before, but that time he managed to jump off. The professor is on his way to meet Bobby. He wonders why Bobby didn't immediately tell about a similar case earlier. Bobby claims that the case actually happened, but all the information is wrong and he was cleared of all charges. Then Bobby tells that a man is imprisoned with him who confessed to the murder of a girl 8 years ago. His name is Blair Sullivan, and he sneers at the fact that the court convicted an innocent Bobby in this case. After some time, the sheriff visits the professor and says he got information that his wife was involved in the case that occurred earlier than the murder. For the professor himself, this was amazing news. Paul's wife, as a former assistant prosecutor, confirms the words of the sheriff. Laurie says she feels guilty that Bobby ended up in prison. Laurie also convinces her husband to help the guy and bring this matter to an end. In the archive, the professor gets acquainted with the cases in which the psychopathic maniac Blair Sullivan is serving his sentence. Then he goes to meet him. In the conversation, Armstrong is trying to get evidence that he really killed the girl. Sullivan does not admit his guilt and shows that he is very interested in the professor. But suddenly, for unknown reasons, the embittered Blair Sullivan in anger points to the split knife with which he showed exactly how he killed the girl. The surprised professor is outraged that the police did not find him. The psycho says that the police didn't pay attention to the road signs. After meeting with the professor, he learns that Blair Sullivan writes letters to the relatives of his victims, who of course do not go anywhere. Having the information that the psycho told Armstrong in prison, the professor goes home to the sheriff to report this. While Tanny Brown is away, Armstrong meets his daughter. The professor learns that the murdered girl Joni Shriver is the sheriff's adopted daughter. Brown appears and kicks Paul out of his house. The professor says that he should not have been allowed to this case from the very beginning. He also mentions a murder weapon that has not been found. Then they go together to the forest where the crime occurred in an attempt to find a knife. After some time of unsuccessful searches, they were going to leave. But before leaving, Armstrong points to a road sign, suspecting that this is the same sign that Blair Sullivan told him about. He rushes towards the sign and continues a thorough search. Some time later, a knife was found in a drain pipe near the sign, presumably with which the girl was killed. Continuing to share details and collect evidence at home with his wife, Professor gets the idea to look for something among the letters sent by a psycho from prison. Armstrong found among many letters found one in which Blair Sullivan described in detail how he killed Joni Shriver. Having evidence as a knife and a letter, a trial was held in the case of 8 years ago, as a result of which Bobby Earl was absolutely acquitted, and the psychopath Blair Sullivan is sentenced to death by electric chair. Later, celebrating the finished business with family, Professor Armstrong received a call. He received a call from the condemned maniac Blair Sullivan, who mentioned a certain collusion between two people and asked the professor to fulfill his last request before the execution. Sullivan gave his parents' address to Armstrong and asked him to apologize to them on his behalf. Paul went to the specified address. No one was waiting for him at the house and responded. So Armstrong went inside. In a dark room, he pulled back the curtains and found two corpses sitting at a table. Then Paul went to the maniac. Blair, wanting his parents to be dead, asked the professor what he saw inside the house. Armstrong realizes that Sullivan is enjoying the fact that his parents are dead. He tells him that his parents are alive and completely forgive him for all the terrible things he has done in his life. This infuriates Blair and talks about collusion with Bobby Earl. Bobby Earl and Blair Sullivan forced the professor to deal with this case so that Bobby would be acquitted and he could kill Sullivan's parents. Armstrong, having recorded the entire conversation on a dictaphone, leaves. At this time, the maniac is put on the electric chair and executed. Paul calls and tells the sheriff everything, which in turn calls Detective Wilcox, who is monitoring Bobby. The professor understands that his family may suffer and goes to the hotel. But Bobby Earl kills Wilcox. Then he kidnaps Armstrong's daughter and wife and takes them away. The professor and Sheriff Tanny Brown give chase to save the family and catch the killer. They find themselves in the forest where the first murder took place. In order to speed up the search, the guys decide to split up. The professor finds a hut in which his wife and daughter are. At the same time, Bobby Earl attacks the sheriff and a fight ensues between them. Armstrong tries to free the family and hears a shot. Bobby Earl appears and throws it away. Bobby is happy that he managed to deceive the professor and will be released from prison. Armstrong reports that Blair Sullivan has been pardoned and includes a tape recorder recording in which Sullivan says he will kill Bobby for not killing his parents. From this, Bobby Earl becomes enraged and is attacked from behind by a survivor after being wounded by Sheriff Tanny Brown. The professor grabs a knife and tries to neutralize Bobby. After some time of a brutal fight to the death between the men, Armstrong manages to make several stabs. After that, Bobby's body is dragged away by a crocodile. Recovering a little after the incident, the professor provides first aid to the sheriff. And together with their family, they are waiting for the police to arrive.